so much, debit card. I abused the fuck out of you. I'm so sorry for what I do. Today is July 2nd. Well, yeah, it's still July 2nd. Gymshark's birthday. And of course, they had a discount. And of course, me being me, had to abuse my debit card. My total was gonna come out to $54 with the ship, $10 shipping. And once the $10 shipping came up, I was like, no thanks, bro. So me being the cheap ass that I am, of course, I had to sign up for student beans for 10% off. Saved me $3. And instead of getting two bottoms, I decided to get one bottom and the beanie. Of course, because I'm cheap. Because I could have just go getting one object and then paying 10 bucks for shipping. What the fuck is that? And then I'm not going to go paying 54 bucks for that shit. So I was like, no thanks, bro. So my total came out to $37. Just gonna make me so sad, man. They're gonna get here within like, 10 days-ish, so mid next month I'm gonna have it, and then I'm gonna be able to rock that shit at the gym. And I'm not only gonna have one pair of bottoms of Gymshark, or just in general, because like, I only have the black bottoms, and I wear those shits all the time. So then with some dark gray and now the beanie, once it gets cold up in Merced, bam, rocking that shit all the time. Of course though, right now, before I did that, I was on my computer editing a photo for my Instagram, because I had a chest day with my friend Enrique today, and damn did I have a nice ass pump, despite me being on a fast for right now. So I made a transformation picture, you guys can see it right here. If you guys want to see it on Instagram itself, go down to the description and follow me. Give me a quick follow. I have some nice pictures on there. And of course, if all this information is like relevant to you and stuff, and like you just find it all interesting and it helps you out and stuff, and you're not subscribed, then you're doing something wrong, my dude. Let's see what happens next though. Next week is gonna be beach trip with my friends. We were supposed to go this Sunday, but they got pushed back because we just couldn't all end up going. So we're pushing it back to next Sunday. But yeah, see you guys then once something interesting happens. Yesterday, something happened and like I was pretty emotionally distressed. I called for my friends to like hang out with them and like fuck around with them. We went to the gym, we went to go eat. We went and had some fun with the BB guns, and it really helped me out. Still feel just a little bit distressed right now. I'm gonna go work out. Tomorrow I'm heading out to the beach with my friends, beach day. We were gonna go last week, but one of the friends bailed and the other one bailed. So then we just couldn't go, so we backed it up to tomorrow. So tomorrow we're going to the beach. We're going to Venice Beach, Santa Monica. Because me and Kevin went there before, as you guys can see from my Gold's Gymshark video. You guys can check it out right there if you guys want to see it. But we went, but we never really got to like fully look around. So we're gonna go around, hang around the beach, go to the pier, have some food. It's gonna be fucking great. So right now I'm gonna go to the gym. I'm gonna go hit some chest and probably hit some deadlifts. Even though I squatted yesterday, I still really, really want to deadlift. I really wanted to deadlift yesterday, but it was already like 30 something by the time we got out. We played basketball and everything. It's really fun. Me and Andy almost won. But yeah, I'm gonna go hit chest right now. Probably gonna narrate it. I'm gonna warm up, then I'm gonna hit some incline, then some flat, and then some dumbbell flat, and then just a dip ladder, and then I'll explain to you guys what all that means and why I do it and stuff. Because my chest is ass, but I always want to be improving it. So let's get over there then.
So pretty much when I start off, especially like on a chest day, I like to make sure that I get like the blood flow in my arms. So I'll do dynamic stretches, not stretches where I keep my arms in place. Then afterwards, I like to make sure that I warm up my back for the stability. I try to extremely make sure I don't go heavy. I go at a weight where I can like really handle it, keep myself in place, keep my core nice and tight, and just rely all on lat pull. That will help out with my stability later on when benching. And then I'll do some overhead press to make sure that my front delts and my side delts are like somewhat warmed up and they have some blood flow in them, just for like they aren't so cramped up when actually doing the bench press. I ended up doing like 3 sets of both, make sure I go light. And then here I finally went up to the bench press. I was doing 10 pounds each side, only for like, I ended up doing like 2 sets of like 30 reps each side. At first I would like go really slow, like for all these warm up sets, I would go like really slow to try to get that nice contraction, and then I would just like pump that shit just to try to get as many reps in as I could. I did the same thing almost for 35, then here I am at a plate. I did one decent rep, and then boom, you see the bars move forward there. Yikes, that shit was so terrible. Oh shit. And then I look scared there. I just feel scared right now just looking at it. I look so fucking scared, trying to get that guy's attention, and then blam, nope, no one notices me, so I have to like deadlift that shit down. Oh, it's so embarrassing. But then afterwards, I was like, yeah, I'm not fucking bench pressing anymore. So I went back up to some incline dumbbell just for some nice cleaner reps. And then I went to flat dumbbell and I made sure I got like a nice under pectoral contraction by like turning the dumbbell inward. That shit's nasty. And then afterwards, I just did some regular flat. And then I had to make sure I didn't forget completely upper because I did some incline only like 2-3 sets, but it was enough. So I just did some dumbbell, whatever the fuck raises, trying to make sure that I fully contracted my upper chest by bringing the dumbbell across me. And then I went with some dips. Those did not feel great at all. Like, I just felt fucking tired. So I went to fucking seated dips because I was a little bitch. And for seated dips, I did a ladder. And oh, those are so terrible. A ladder is pretty much where you start off from the heaviest or one of the heavier weights that you can possibly go to. You do like a set of whatever number. Usually I aim for 10 for these sets. And then I drop the weight to next lighter weight, then 10 reps, then next lighter weight, 10 reps, next, etc. Until I burned out here and went to the restroom and had this nasty pump. Ass just had the like not the worst but a terrible chest workout right now. I had a gnarly pump at the end though. It looked really nice over there in the lighting. I've noticed that a higher angle makes me look a lot nicer than like a lower angle. But of course, I want to assume that the reason why I didn't do well today was only because, for one, I only slept 4 hours, which is ass compared to how I usually sleep. Usually get like at least a good solid 8 hours, so that's half of what I usually sleep. And then I've probably only eaten like 800 calories. And usually I head to the gym with like a good 2,000 under my belt, so that's why I just had no strength in me whatsoever. I just felt completely weak. Yeah, I saw earlier on my incline, I was in my third set, right? And then all of a sudden I just completely failed it. And that thing just ruined my tempo for the rest of the workout. I managed to push through it. Overall, did well. But I'm not sure if you guys saw. So the bar fell onto my chest, right? Before I was rudely interrupted by my like memory card filling up while explaining that, pretty much on that last rep for fucking incline, I go all the way down, right? And I'm like coming up and I'm like, oh my gosh, I gotta pull a fucking Hulk right now. I gotta push this thing up because if not, I'm gonna die. And so then I went up and then like it started going down and I was like, oh nope, this is not going up anymore. And the guy that was doing bench press next to me, he walks by me because he's using the Smith and the bench press, and he walks by me and I'm dead ass staring at him, trying to get his attention, but I can be like, and then like he looks at me, looks at me for a split second and turns away and I'm like, fuck! Then like, and I look over here to my right and no one's over there. And so I'm like, damn, I got this weight on me and I don't know what to do. So what I decided to do, I was like, wait, this is only a plate. So I just like put it on my lap and then stood up and then just deadlifted it all the way down. So luckily I didn't hurt myself. That's a pro of having a bench that's way weaker than your deadlift. The con is that I have a weak ass bench. And correction, I don't usually eat 2,000 calories before going to the gym. I usually eat like about a good 1,200, and then I'll consume like another 600 or 800 by the end of the day. Because I try to make sure I go under 2,000 calories in my daily intake for that I can like continue losing weight. But yeah, as you guys saw over there in the lockers, my aesthetic is getting a lot slimmer. I'm getting a lot more lean. My abs are coming in. My chest pump bump was like bumping, pumping. So I'm gonna be looking nice and fresh tomorrow for the beach. But I need to clean myself up and then make sure I go to sleep early because I need to head to my friend's house by 8 in the morning before we can head out and then have like most of the day over there. I'm gonna film everything. I'll see you guys there. Excuse me for the steering wheel being in the way. I don't even know if I can drive like this because I'm afraid that you're gonna fall down right now. Hi, Chihuahua. It is 7:28 according to my clock, but that's like 5 minutes early. I have to go pick up Joaquin right now, who is a good 15-20 minutes away from where I live. I don't know if I should pick up Kevin first, but I have to go pick up Joaquin first, and then from there I'm going to Wesley's house, and we're all gonna meet up there. I'll introduce you guys to Joaquin and Wesley once we're there.
I don't think I've fully introduced him into my channel for a good long while since back from fucking Bean Boozle Challenge of 100 subscribers. God damn, that was a long ass time ago. Fucking years ago. A good 2 years ago, almost. I've been on YouTube for so fucking long. I'm fucking good at what I do. I'm musicless right now because I want to save my battery, but you know what? Fuck it, let's fucking put some music on, boy. I'll see you guys when we go pick up Joaquin right now because I'm about to hit up the streets now. Why the fuck does it do that? Shit, it's fucking loud. Yeah, we. Hello?
Yeah.
Are you awake?
I think so.
I think you're sleeping. Wake up.
I don't think I am.
Wake up!
Yeah.
Come on, we have to go. I'm outside.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Your dad's looking at me outside the window.
Yeah, bye.
Okay. I was thinking for a second there that I was gonna have to break into his house, even with his dad there, because I've done that before with Kevin, but I guess I'm not doing that, just gonna wait. Look who it is! Rise and shine! For a while, I was like, oh, fuck, he's not gonna fucking wake up, and I'm gonna have to break in, fucking wake him up myself, and get arrested because his dad's there. I fucking told you he was gonna have a hoodie on.
You have to take your hoodie off.
Kevin wants to see the whole thing.
Take your hoodie off or you can't come in.
I told you he fucking looks like One Punch Man.
You can squeeze into there, dude.
Oh, they'll be fucked up, dude.
You can squeeze into there.
I lost my head because fucking steroids. But you know, when you called me, I kind of woke up.
Yeah, I had just woken up Joaquin too when I called him.
Really?
Yeah.
We're legit like brothers. I wish you buzzed your head again,
though. No.
Dude, Mexican ladies keep fucking up my hair. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's my head shape or something. They fuck that shit up good. I legit paid $10 to get a haircut just to go home and buzz it.
Take your head off.
I showed you the beach.
Bro. Take your head off.
Dude, I showed you on Snapchat. Don't be fucking bitch, right?
Yeah, well, I was like asleep, dude. I opened that shit. I just closed it in. So, like,
really?
Take your head off.
Fucking sucks.
Take your head off.
Huh?
Take your head off.
What the fuck happened? You know what you look like? You look like when X went to jail.
What up, Wesley?
I'm wearing
a jacket, dude. You gotta cover his hair, that's why.
Dude, I buzzed my head. I look like One Punch Man.
Because of the door?
I started taking steroids. And then my hair started coming out.
A Tesla sweater.
What the fuck?
Why did y'all seem surprised by that? He actually likes Tesla for some reason.
Tesla?
That's why we went into the... Yeah, that's why we went to the Tesla store at La Brea.
I didn't know Tesla made merch. I thought it was joking.
Dude, I honestly have no idea.
Hey,
give me a hint.
New
YouTuber.
Hair?
YouTuber?
Yeah.
It's new hair.
I think
it's
fucking...
Oh! I think I know what it's gonna be, too.
It's new hair.
I wanna say rice gum stuff, dude.
Rice gum?
Yeah.
It's new
no,
hair.
No, I wanna think...
Fuck!
I wanna think it's Danny.
Danny Duncan?
No.
No?
No.
Oh, fuck. How many subscribers do you have?
Two. I don't know.
193.
It's John's merch.
I don't even
watch your fucking channel anymore, dude.
No fucking way, dude.
And he fucking walks out. The fuck is it?
You're gonna be jealous.
I know what it is.
What is it?
Open it first.
No, guess what it is.
It's David Dobrik merch.
How'd you know?
He asked me if I got you that, because remember when I got you gym shirt? He thought it was David Dobrik, I think, right? He's been wrestling with me.
I didn't give me a gift.
Hey, I took you out.
Huh?
I took you out. And then you paid for me.
Mr. Wife and the soul come. Hmm?
What?
Come
that was legit the reason? It was too far?
No,
wait. Yeah, I guess.
First he said it was his grandma's birthday, and then he said
no.
It's too far.
For real.
Yeah, he said, I don't know which one it is.
Just any excuses.
No, I miss.
Oh,
I don't know you have a switch.
Your own hair.
I've never heard that.
Two. Isn't it really from high school for making fun of you?
Yeah.
Wonder where I go. Learn a lot from this and it's something that I know. Put it in five. I'll be on the side. I'll be on the way. I'll be on the way. You can be me in five. I'll be your nine. I'll be your all day. I'll be on the way.
What do you do? Oh, you have to put it after the fucking.
Dude, I don't even dig it that much. Oh. Why is this hard?
Fucking picky, bro. It's not that fucking cold. Holy fuck, yeah, it's fucking cold. I'm not gonna have to walk in that it's not that it's cold though. See, because if it's cold, it's not gonna fucking go in, so it's warm. It's actually not that cold, surprisingly. It's actually warm. I think it's because of yesterday. Because yesterday was warm, but how fucking hot. Let's go. The water's warm. We're already wet and we're drying up right now. For the most part, I have cotton shorts on, so I'm fucking wet and I'm gonna be sitting down over there wet. But we're all hungry, we haven't eaten yet, and for the most part, we were up at like 7, 8 ish, so we need food. So, Johnny Rockets, it is. Who the fuck am I talking to?
You're 19 feet. No, I'm just kidding.
That's I'm fun. Talking to Saul, okay?
Fuck. I'm your number one supporter. I watch every video.
I'm hurt now.
I'm just kidding, dude. You guys made fun of my chest.
Oh, God. I'm a fucking die trying this. Let go.
Just kind of let go.
Just let go. Just let go. Okay. I'm chairing the rope first, then I let go.
If you slide down, you get rope burn.
Hey, Wesley, you use your legs, huh?
You going up there?
Yeah, but I'm not doing legs.
I feel like Kevin's gonna eat it.
No, he's not. Oh, he's fucking tiring already.
Fuck.
Don't let go. Don't let go. Don't let fucking go.
Oh, it's fucking scary.
No, it's fucking scary, dude. Okay. I was barely halfway. I looked down.
Damn.
Holy crap. No, I'm fucking scared.
Wait, did I go higher than John at least?
Yes, he did.
I could keep going, but I was fucking scared.
Yeah, dude, it's not even my fatigue.
Come on, John.
Holy crap.
Right.
How the fuck am I gonna ask those two questions? John.
When I say allergic, I'm allergic because you guys won't leave me like.
The sand is legit hot, John. Stop. I swear to fucking God, I will kill you.
Hey, what's up, YouTube?
We're about to go to the gym.
Hey, what's up, YouTube? Today we're hitting legs
and biceps
with David Lade. Yeah, dude, it's so awkward vlogging. Hey, what's up, YouTube? Hey, what's up, YouTube?
What are you talking
to, it's me, Caillou, with my friend Binky from Arthur.
I got fat cheeks.
Hey, what's up, YouTube? It's David Lade, Quinn Vitale,
Jonah Hill.
So we just finished eating at Johnny Rockets.
We thought Johnny Rockets, but we actually ate at Johnny Rockets. So I'm here with
Red Rocket,
David Lade, Red Rocket, and Jonah Hill. I welcome them. Hopefully we have a good beach session. We're gonna hit legs, but for some reason we're gonna bench press first. I'll see you guys there though, because I don't know what the fuck. But yeah.
Nice angles.
I got it.
You're so strong and handsome.
Always say what you mean.
Do YouTubers know that my balls are small?
They do now.
No, they don't.
You're right. You're right. They don't know. And they won't know because I won't put that in there.
I gotta be in the car once it changes because of the rule.
It's the rule.
Sorry, it's the rule. I have to be in here.
He has to watch you.
Dude, show me your dick already. What makes it so different from that? Okay, I might be horny. I might be fucking
hungry.
I'm a little hungry. No matter how hot it is.
You wear hoodies wherever you go because of your hair.
Okay. That's a little too far right there.
So pretty much, we all took
beast ass naps.
We all took beast ass naps.
Kevin got
and then,
fucking burned.
Yeah, and then his fucking traps burn.
He looks like a crab.
And Joaquin almost fucking shat himself in the restroom because he said it smelled like ass.
Oh, this was a
and now we're here to go to eat sushi because we're all hungry. We kind of fucked up.
I eat this one, and then we all take two. No, I'm not eating anymore.
Dude, it's fair. It's fair. You guys have to share them.
How about this? I'll pay the extra.
How much do you think it is? $4? So that'd be like $13 because that dish itself is like 13. We pretty much finished eating and everything. We had like these two nasty ass rolls of eels. I couldn't eat any because I'm allergic to eels specifically. But my friends and them, they were fucking suffering hella hard with that. They said it was fucking nasty. They fucking felt that slime right down their throat. And we were gonna get charged if we had any leftovers, but we managed to eat it all. That shit was a lot. We ate a total of like 17 rolls. And it came out to like $130-something. My broke ass only had $28, so. Pretty much that's all we're gonna do today. Been up to like 7, then we're gonna head back. I'm gonna fucking knock out when I get back, honestly. I'm fucking tired. Thank you guys for watching.
Get the fuck out the hood of my car.
Loving is easy. You had me fucked up. It used to be so hard to see. Yeah, loving is easy when everything's